Welcome, both of you. Let's hear your names, please.
I'm Stuart Walker.
And I'm Jenna Walker. We're brother and sister.
Okay. And where are you from?
We're Toronto, Canada.
Woo! That's my country.
What kind of music are you into?
Country music.
Country. Brilliant. Do you write your own songs?
We do. We're actually going to perform an original song. It's called People Don't Talk About.
And tell me what it's about.
We wrote this song probably 2 years ago. Our family's been through a lot of stuff that we kind of didn't feel comfortable talking about, and we wrote it about that.
I grew up playing cowboys. I like to play pretend. Bunch of kids in a backyard, back when it made sense.
We would speak our minds and say just what we meant. That was the old me. Nobody told me that everything changes.
Reality sets in.
You better keep quiet if you wanna fit in.
People don't talk about when it's 2 a.m. You're talking to yourself again. You're digging a hole. You're digging a hole. People don't talk about trying to be yourself, but feeling like you're someone else. You're not alone. You're not alone. Whoa. I wanna know everything that you don't say out loud. Yeah, all the things that people don't talk about. 'Cause people don't talk about.
Take a load off, take a breath, say it all, then say the rest. If you let it out, you can let him in.
Take a load off, take a breath, say it all, then say the rest. If you let it out,
you can let him in.
People don't talk about when it's 2 a.m. You're talking to yourself again. You're digging a hole, you're digging a hole.
People don't talk about trying to be.
Good, you two. Howie, you're on your feet.
First of all, your singing and your writing is impeccable. And I don't usually respond to lyrics like I'm responding to this. You know, I've been very open. My little soapbox is mental health, and there's a stigma attached. And the thing that allows me to survive is the ability to talk about it. This song is an important song, and I think that you are going to go a long way in this competition.
Wow.
Thank you.
Yeah, I liked it too. I like the song. I love that you're siblings. I also feel that you really want it, and I feel like you deserve it.
Wow. Thank you.
You did the right thing coming tonight to AGT because it was like a big treat for all of us. It was impeccable.
Thank you. Thank you guys so much.
That was a great, great audition. Seriously good. Unbelievably powerful. That song was stunning. So, Howie, yes or no?
Yes.
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 Okay, that makes it 4 yeses. Congratulations.
Smiling.
Gosh, you've brought a lot of people with you. Tell me your names, please.
So I'm Ravi, and this is my sister Mara, and this is my mum and dad.
Very, very nice to meet you. And how old are you?
So I'm 8 years old.
Okay. What made you decide to do this?
I've watched BGT all my life and always wanted to audition for it. And 2 years ago, I was diagnosed with a brain tumour, and I'm here to show no matter what life throws at you, you can still achieve your dreams.
Good for you.
And how are you right now?
So my brain tumor is stable, but I'm still living with the day-to-day effects.
So you've had a really tough time, haven't you?
Yeah.
Tell me about all these people behind you.
So to support me, I brought a group of my friends and teachers from school, my family,
yeah,
some medical professionals who have helped me during my diagnosis,
yeah,
some other amazing children from the brain tumour community.
Oh, God. Mum and Dad are joining in.
And what are you going to be doing for us today?
So today we're doing a choir performance of A Million Dreams.
Oh, my God.
Okay. Take your time. Whenever you're ready, we're ready.
Golden buzzer is such a personal thing, and I always say I can only press it when it feels right. And you're such a remarkable young man.
You're a hero.
You really are.
The moment you started talking, you just had me.
Yeah.
What did you say? And I just loved it.
Oh,
so
God.
Well done to all of you.
Thank you for doing it.
Yes, thank you.
My name's Richard Goodall from Terre Haute, Indiana. I've lived in Terre Haute my whole life. I was that kid up in my bedroom with the Radio Shack stereo. My favorite thing was just to sit up and listen to my music, and then I'd just belt it out. Eventually, I was like, I gotta find me a job. So I became a janitor at Chauncey Rose Middle School, which is only 3 blocks away from my house.
My first job in L.A. was sweeping floors, and I used to sing to myself. That's the thing.
That's how I keep up my voice. Is this? I'm not a fancy person. I take out the trash, I wipe off the tables, I sweep the floors. I'm just having fun, and I'm trying to make people happy. The kids would hear me sing, and they tell me, I've got talent. That's why I'm here. That's why I got on a plane. When I took off from Indianapolis, felt that front wheel come off the ground, and you have this floating, you're no longer stable. And that's what this whole experience is like right now. I mean, it's a good off balance, but until you actually do something, you don't know if it's right for you or not. Oh, I'm getting chicken skin talking about it.
It's time to meet the judges. Thank you, sir. I'm with you.
Hello. Very nice to meet you. And what is your name, please?
I'm Richard Goodall. I'm from Terre Haute, Indiana.
And Richard, how old are you?
I'm 55.
55. And what do you do for a living?
I've been a janitor for 23 years. The kids call me Mr. Richard.
Okay. So tell me what the big dream is, please.
My big dream? I like to sing. I love to sing. So.
Okay. Does everyone know you've come out today to audition?
Just my close-knit friends and my fiancée, Angie.
Oh. Is she here with you today?
No.
So she's the one you're going to call... Yeah. After the audition, yeah?
Yes, immediately, yes.
Okay, all right. And the song you've chosen today, tell me why you chose it.
The song speaks for itself, so...
Okay, all right. I'm not going to ask any more questions. Let's do it. Good luck.
Ooh.
Ah, are you a bit nervous?
Yeah.
It's okay, Richard.
This has been a long time coming. So.
Oh, bless you.
Let's go, Richard!
Shake off those nerves. We're here. We're rooting for you, Richard. Good luck. I hope he's good.
I know, I hope
I really
so.
Do.
Just a small town girl.
Oh my God.
Living in a lonely world.
What?
She took a midnight train going anywhere. Just a city boy. Born and raised in South Detroit. He took a midnight train.
Please open the door. Nothing is there.
Richard, you are my hero.
Facing these halls, trying to talk.
Because that was special. Genuinely special. I think America is gonna love you.
I mean, that was spectacular. That was fun. This was an amazing surprise. I think you were perfect to come to AGT because you made our night.
Thank you, man. You're beautiful.
You, and maybe because you've been doing it for 23 years, but you just cleaned up. You just... You know, I would imagine every kid that has ever been in a school with you is just screaming, I just think you're amazing. We love you, Richard! Yeah.
Richard, 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 you knocked me off my feet. I mean, we all had the best time with you up there on that stage. I really, really feel something when I see you up there and hear you up there. And now... This is what I'm gonna do for you because I love you.
I'm late, but I'm here right now. Though I used to be romantic, I forgot somehow. Time can make you blind, but I see you now as we're outsiders inside the home that we built. The cold settles in. It's been a long winter.
He deserves it.
And now I think we should go and call your fiance. Should we call her?
Go call her.
Oh my gosh, you guys. I've never even been on a plane. This was not on my radar to come to California. It's just a dream come true.
Happy you came.
Give it up one more time for Richard Goodall.
Yes, I'm here right now.
Oh! Hi, we are the Phoenix Boys.
And where are you boys from?
We're from all over the UK.
All our friends and family are in the audience today and we can't wait to show them how hard we've worked. And I hope they're so proud of us.
So, we got this.
If you went on to win Britain's Got Talent, what would you spend the money on?
So, we would spend it on a new facility, a permanent facility for Phoenix to meet up more often and so that we can have somewhere to go to. And the rest would probably go towards our families and college funds.
Amazing. Well, you're off the hook. I'm not going to ask you any more questions. I'm just going to say, make the next 3 or 4 minutes count. Good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
There's a feeling, there's a fire, there's a whisper preaching to the choir. Take the leaders and the liars, throw your fears in the funeral pyre. Keep on breathing, don't go hungry. Mother, sister, father, brother, step into the light and start a tiny fire. Stop being so goddamn cross. Push away your pain, turn the power in the rain to a tidal haven fire.
time here.
People don't really understand how hard it is to succeed as a dancer. The work that goes into it and the passion, and literally you do it for nothing, you do it for love. And I felt that.
Emotional. I understand.
Congratulations, boys. I could see the emotional connection that Bruno felt, and I knew that he could see himself in you. Amanda?
I loved it. I loved the choreography. I really loved the power and the energy that you all have. And I love the fact that there's age difference between you all, because I can see there's mentoring and care and friendship in this group. So for me, that meant everything.
Bruno.
I literally can't speak. What really touches people is when you perform from your heart, is the truth of your performance. That's really what remains in people's mind. And you touch me. And I think you touched everybody here.
Good evening.
Hello.
How are you?
A little nervous, but also very nervous.
What is your name?
My name is Stephanie Rainey.
How old are you?
I'm 36.
I'm guessing you're going to sing for us tonight?
I am.
And for how long you've been doing this?
Oh, since I was probably 18.
Is this your first time, like, attempting to be in a competition like AGT?
Yeah, I've had a very kind of roller coaster career, I would say. The song that I'm going to play for you today has had quite a big moment in the past. And we made it in just a tiny room and put it up one Monday morning. And it just, by the end of the day, it had a million views.
Wow.
And then I signed a deal after the song came out. I think I probably didn't fully know who I was back when I signed that deal. The journey from then until now has been hard. It's a tough industry, you know?
Yeah.
You have to be resilient. And I think sometimes when the downs come, you have to be willing to kind of pick yourself back up.
Yeah.
So here I am.
So the song is called?
It's called Please Don't Go. I wrote it about losing my nephew when I was a teenager. He was about to turn one. It was the day before his first birthday and he passed away.
Oh, sorry.
And it took me a long time to write a song about it. Honestly, I was about to give up music. So I was like, I want to make something for me that I believe in. So this song means more to me than I can actually, like, even describe.
Good for you for doing that and not giving up. I do know how difficult the music business is. There's so many great people who are giving up. And that's why a platform like this is still really, really important.
Absolutely.
And who do you play with?
My best friend, Sarah, she's here with me today, and she's been on every single step of this journey with me from the very beginning.
Okay, well, look, we're rooting for you.
Thank you.
Your hand till it goes cold. I hold my tears until you go. With all the life that leaves your bones, it soaks the purpose from my own.
Heartfelt song. We can tell what you went through. It was very simple and perfect.
Very few acts move people, and that was one of the most relatable, emotional moments we've had on season 19. So thank you so much.
Oh, yeah. Your voice sounded amazing on this stage. It was just a real special moment.
Well done. Thank you.
Of all the new songs I've heard this year, this is the best by a mile. And even though it's about something really sad, it's real. And your voice is beautiful. A lot of people are going to resonate with that song and you. I absolutely love this.
Thank you so much.
Stephanie, I'm
going
to give you your first yes.
I'm also gonna give you a yes.
Yes.
I think I'm gonna give you about 4,000 yeses.
Who have we got here? Hello.
Callie.
Callie.
Savannah.
Savannah. And are you sisters? And who have you brought with you today?
Nanny.
So is she your mummy's mummy or your daddy's mummy?
Daddy's mummy.
Daddy's mummy. Okay, brilliant. And can I ask Savannah, how old are you?
3.
Amazing. And Callie, how old are you?
4.
Oh.
cute.
What are we here for?
To surprise Dad.
What's going on?
Well, Nick doesn't know anything about it, and we're surprising him because we want him to come and sing, because he sings a lovely song for the girls. Oh. Come along, Nick.
I've just seen him.
Unbelievable.
Come on, Nick.
Oh my goodness me.
Oh wow.
You just thought you were having a lovely day out.
I did. We had a whole day planned.
Well, that's changed.
Yeah, this is complete shock to me.
He said he'd never do it, so we had to do it for him.
Why did you say you'd never do it?
I think over the years, I've lost a lot of confidence in my singing. So, I tend to do it at home, in the shower. You know?
Oh. Well, I'll tell you what.
Gosh.
Nick, I'll tell you what, why don't you go off, grab a glass of water, and then come back on? Would that be a good idea?
Thank you.
Nick, literally thought you'd run away.
I notice you've got your words down there, which is totally fine. Do whatever it takes to get through it.
It's a song that I felt quite attached to, so I sing it quite a lot around the house. So hopefully I'll keep the nerves and the crying away whilst I'm singing it.
Bless you. Yeah. Well, we are all rooting for you, aren't we?
Thank you.
Always be, yeah, to me, you'll
I'm fine. Yeah, I'm fine.
It was so sweet. You got a nice voice.
You have such a beautiful voice. It's just, it was a really, really lovely surprise. What did you think, David?
Well, it was just so moving from start to finish. And, you know, you just looked like you were going to burst into tears every word, actually. But yeah, I felt like there's not a dry eye in the house. And that really hit me emotionally more than anything else today.
Well, it was absolutely gorgeous. Me and Alicia are in bits.
We have to vote. I'm going to say yes.
It's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
Well, I think you've got 4,004 yeses.
I get to love you. I get to love you.
Oh, well done, Nick.
I get to love you. I get to
Thank you.
Love you.
Hello, welcome.
Hi, how are you doing?
We're good. How are you, more importantly?
We're a bit nervous. I need a wee, but I'm fine.
Tell us your names, please.
I'm Denise.
And I'm Stefan.
OK, and how do you know each other?
We're married. Oh, sorry.
Where did you meet?
We're both involved with an award ceremony, and Denise was presenting, and I was the guy playing piano for 2 hours while everyone else has a three-course meal.
Got it.
But we met on the tube train going there, and I didn't realise he was the bloke who was playing for me that evening, and he leaned over and asked me for the time. It was 2006, so, you know, people did that then. Well, the chances of a blind man asking a blind woman on a train for the time...
And that was how many years ago?
That was 18 years ago.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you. Do you have any kids?
Yeah, I've got 3 older ones. 2 of them are here today. And then we've got one together. Dimitri, he's 11.
I'm talking about you.
Okay, well, nice to meet you both. And why this year BGT? Tell us.
Well, let's be honest, as performers, the last few years haven't been a lot of fun. And then just as everybody was getting back into work, I was diagnosed with cancer. Oh. And so I was having chemo and having half of my favourite boob taken off. Thelma and Louise.
My goodness, and how are you now?
I'm fine, I've had a clear scan and my hair's grown back.
And you got a whole new head of hair, which is a totally different colour and curly.
I was a ginge before.
OK, so you come through it, and now you thought, right, we're going to come on BGT.
Yeah, we just want to grab the bull by the horns, you know, and just take every opportunity. Yeah.
OK, well, look, Amazing. We are really rooting for you.
Steph will just grope his way around the piano.
You think I was blind or something, don't you?
They're very funny, old mum and dad.
That all the time.
Does he?
Are you ready?
Thank you.
single person in the theatre is on their feet.
Takes it all, loses standing small, the size of victory.
I'm a mess, this show is killing me. I can't bear it.
Demetria, what did you think of your parents' performance?
Very impressive and good.
Very impressive.
We always say this, you know, without people like you, this show is nothing. And it's true. I'm so happy that you made the decision to come on our show. I think you're both amazing people.
Thank you.
Your whole attitude is actually quite unbelievable.
Alicia.
In the opening chat, I thought, well, you're so naturally funny. I wondered whether you were going to do comedy.
Yes, I hope you weren't disappointed.
No, no. That vocal was faultless. It was beautiful.
I'm actually inspired by you. I've learned something today about your positive state of mind and the ability to have a sense of humor about yourself.
We all need to know that.
You are an example. You really have. I admire you. I've been inspired by you.
Bruno, yes or no?
Yes.
The judges will decide.
Alicia.
Huge yes for me.
Amanda.
100% yes for me.
Always stay in love.
That's about a million yeses. Congratulations.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm all right, thank you.
Are you the last auditionee tonight?
I am the last one today.
Okay. Been a long day, right?
It has been a long day, but I'm ready.
You know, but this is, if you ever watched X Factor before, it often goes, it's the end of a long day, and our last contestant is silently waiting in the wings.
Yeah.
And you know what happens then.
Yeah, it either goes very good or very bad.
Yeah, one of the two. So tell me about you.
So I'm 21. I'm from Billingham in Teesside.
Yep.
I'm a car mechanic.
Yeah.
And then obviously I sing a little bit as well.
And you live on your own?
I live with my mum.
Okay.
Just me and my mum.
Cool.
Oh, I love it. You say mum like me.
Yeah, she's my rock, so.
And what are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing Jealous by Labyrinth.
And tell me why you've chosen that song.
It means a lot to me for a different reason, I think, to how Labyrinth wrote it.
Which is?
I lost my best friend a couple of years ago, and I kind of interpret the lyrics in a completely different way.
I lost my best friend 2 years ago. He was only 18 at the time, and we were really, really close. We did everything together.
We got a call saying we had to go to the hospital because he wasn't going to last the day. And I know that was tough on Josh.
Sorry. The lyrics kind of say, I'm jealous that you're happy without me. And I kind of see it in the sense that I'm jealous that he's now happy in heaven, that he's moved on to a better place and that I can't still be with him.
Best of luck, Josh.
Thank you.
Come on, son. Come on.
I'm jealous of the rain that falls upon my skin. It's closer than my hands have been. Oh, I'm jealous of the rain. 'Cause I wish you the best of. thought you'd come back. Tell me all you found was heartbreak and misery. It's hard for me to say I'm jealous of the way you're happy without me.
Josh, honestly, wow. I was. That was the most captivated I've been in all the auditions so far.
Thank you.
Very emotional, and you really touched me. I believed every word you sang. I kind of want to hug you.
I'll have a hug. I'll accept a hug.
Well done.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Nicholas.
Oh, Josh, that really got me right in the heart. I was completely transfixed. Like, I didn't want it to end.
Thank you. Wow. Thank you so much.
Josh, I'm going to kick this off with a very emotional yes.
Also, you're getting a yes from me, Josh.
Thank you.
I think it was awesome.
Thanks a lot. Appreciate it. Thank you.
He has three yeses.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Manchester, for your time. I appreciate it. Thank you.
This amazing looking group.
We are called Unity. We're all friends in college, so we decided to put this group together to perform a piece called I Will, okay, which is about being told that you can't or you're not enough, and how as a group that we come together and power through that.
Lovely. I love that she's giving you the mic and he's like, why are you handing it to me? What's
What's your name, young man?
My name's Kieran.
Kieran, what would you do if you were to win the money? Would you split it between all of you?
We'd have to figure that one out.
Or you're just a calculator, darling, divide.
Do you think you can win?
I certainly hope so.
Okay, good luck. The stage is yours.
Thank you very much.
John, don't get it. And you can't tell Grandma, 'cause her heart can't take it, and she might not make it.
I'm Declan, and labels don't define me. I push the gender boundaries, but don't allow discrimination to change who I am. People stare and say things. They try to label me. They say I can't be who I am. I will.
They say don't dare, don't you even go there, cutting off your long hair, you do as you're told. Till you wake up, go put on your makeup, this is just a phase you're gonna outgrow. There's something wrong in the village, in the village. Oh, they stare in the village, in the village. Oh, there's nothing wrong with you. It's true, it's true. There's something wrong with the village, with the village. There's something wrong with the village.
I'm Steph.
I'm Libby.
And we are in love. Since we came out, we constantly have eyes on us.
For something as simple as holding hands walking down the street.
Well, as a male and female can kiss in public, and no one would look twice.
They don't want us to show our love.
We will.
There's nothing wrong with you. It's true. It's true. There's something wrong with the village. With the village. Something wrong with the village.
I'm Junior.
Growing up, I was bullied for my love of dance. Dancing makes me feel free and allows me to act out my feelings in a safe place. Bullies ruined this. I was beaten up and called names, all because a boy loved to dance.
I'm Kira. Society has conditioned me to believe that I will never be good enough because of my size, that I will be unsuccessful if I don't change my shape. People say I'll never make it. I will.
Something wrong in the village, in the village. Oh, they stare in the village, in the village. Oh, there's nothing wrong with you. It's true, it's true. There's something wrong with the village, with the village. Something wrong with the village.
Our abilities aren't hindered because of our differences. Our talents aren't any less because we are unique. Our worth isn't defined by our diversity. It is not our differences that divide us. It is our inability to recognise, accept, embrace and celebrate those differences.
Never judge somebody on the way they wear their body, but I pull myself to pieces. I don't know why I do. If I could only learn to see myself how other people do, I'd say I'm not my thoughts. This is my house and these are my rules.
Expected that.
can be anything you want and anyone you want to be in life. The message is loud and clear. The execution, artistically, your choreography was superb. It really is a fantastic performance at every level. I had goosebumps, that's all I can say.
Well, it was such a beautiful...
The audience want a gold, but there aren't any golds left.
We're not pressing anyway. Doesn't care.
I've already done it twice. I can't anymore.
For me, it was such a beautiful, passionate piece. The message was so strong. Everything that you stand for, all of your personalities, the love that you have for each other, all the different characters involved in this group, all of that made this such an amazing and special piece. It was beautiful.
I thought that actually was astonishing. The way that you got your message across, it was so strong. It was an audition I'll never forget. What you've done it your way. And look, we don't have any golden buzzers left.
They'd be nailed on for a golden buzzer if we had any left.
But sometimes I feel you should just break the rules.
Hello, hello, welcome.
Hello.
What's your name?
My name is Jade Massieu.
How old are you?
I just turned 15 years old.
15? Wow, incredible, very young. What are you going to be doing for us today?
Today I'm going to be singing for you.
How do you feel? Are you nervous?
Kind of nervous, but I'm not. I'm more nervous about the talking than the singing part.
You're more nervous about this part right here?
Uh-huh.
Really? Why is that?
Well, I've been diagnosed with autism a few years ago, and talking always been hard for me. That's why I'm singing. I can just express myself.
Absolutely. Who is here with you today?
Well, I got my mom off stage right here.
Hey! Let me ask you this. You're on the biggest stage in Canada. Why CGT?
I want to win.
That's what's up. Well, I love that. Best of luck to you. The stage is yours.
Thank you.
Look at me. You may think you see who I really am, but you never know me. Every day it's as if I play a part. Now I see if I wear a mask, I can fool the world, but I cannot fool my heart.
Reflection, who I am inside.
don't be afraid. I'll bring you home, I'll keep you safe.
Thank you so much.
Girl! You have range!
Thank you so much.
I cannot believe I was listening to a 15-year-old. That was incredible.
You are a perfect example of what a million-dollar winner could look like on this season of CGT.
Absolutely. This is Canada's Got Talent, and sweetheart, you showed this theater, you showed the judges, and more importantly, yourself, that you've got talent. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
I think that this stage in this country is about diversity, and that includes neurodiversity. And that spectrum allows you to shine in different ways than another person. You are a beautiful young lady with an amazing talent. You really are. And what do you want in life? What are you looking for?
I want to be a singer and just travel the world with my singing.
You want that? You want that dream?
Yes, definitely.
How can that come true for you?
Canada's Got Talent.
With Canada's Got Talent.
Yes.
So you want to be on again, right?
Yes.
You want to go farther than you've already gone.
Definitely.
I can help. I can help you. I can give you this.
We are the Five Star Boys.
Great name. Love that. Okay, give us your names and ages, please.
I'm Bo, and I'm 12 years old.
Hello, Bo.
I'm Toby, and I'm 11 years old.
Hello, Toby.
I'm Adam, and I'm 10 years old.
Hello, Adam.
I'm Joey, and I'm 10 years old.
Hello, Joey.
I'm Ollie, and I'm 11 years old.
OK, well, you've obviously been rehearsing for this. This is the big day. This is the big moment. When you woke up this morning, it was like, what were you thinking?
Nervous as
yeah.
anything.
And excited?
Yeah.
Yeah. Is yeah. this real?
And why are you here?
We're trying to spread the word for boys who dance because it's not always easy for us. We get bullied.
We kind of just say to ourselves, we know we're better than them.
But like, if boys can dance if they want to, it's not gonna affect anybody else.
And yeah. they're just people that are jealous of you.
Yeah. Well, we're your friends. If you won, what would you do with the dough?
Buy a flight to go to Disneyland.
Yes!
But also give it to people that need it more than us.
Aww.
Like me!
Good luck.
Thank you.
Have you ever felt like nobody was there? Have you ever felt forgotten in the middle of nowhere? Have you ever felt like you could disappear? Like you could fall and no one would hear? Even when the dark comes crashing through, when you need a friend to carry you, and when you're broken on the ground, you will be found. So let the sun come streaming in, 'cause you'll reach up and you'll rise again. Lift your head and look around. You will be found. You will be found. You will be found.
cold blocks.
Do you ever feel already buried deep?
Feet
under screams, but no one seems to hear a thing. Do you know that there's still a chance for you? Cause there's a spark in you. You just got to ignite the light.
Look what it means to him!
Shine, just turn the night like the 4th of July.
Oh my gosh, you've reduced me to tears. I thought it was an extraordinary piece. And I just think you should feel enormously proud of yourselves because it was beautiful. It really was.
It was perfect. You guys are sensational.
Collectively, you were just stunning, and I loved everything about it. You're just the most gorgeous boys, and your parents must be so proud, honestly.
Wow, 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 wow. You know, there was something about you when you walked out. And look, I know this is tough, what you told us, but I promise you, you stand there now as 5 strong boys who can say to all of those idiots, well, you can't do what we just did. For me, this was the best audition we've seen all day.
Right, well, now the important part. Let me kick this off with a yes! You have 4 yeses.
Big deep breath. We can do this.
Hello.
Hi there. Hello.
What's your name?
I'm Dermot Parlin. I'm the head teacher of Flakefleet Primary School, and this is our choir.
Hi.
Hello.
So tell me a little bit about the choir and how long they've been singing together.
Probably since September. We're a real eclectic group. We've got ranges from 4 all the way through to 11. Some are amazing singers, some are just enthusiastic. I'm not being...
That's a nice way of putting it.
No. Do you know what?
I'm going to use that in future.
That is funny.
You were enthusiastic.
So what's the big dream for this choir?
Reading and writing is important at school, but the kids had a dream. This one in assembly said she wanted to go on Britain's Got Talent, and here we are.
Amazing. What's your name?
Megan.
How old are you, Megan?
7.
7. And why did you want to come on Britain's Got Talent?
Because I love singing.
Oh, darling. Oh, well, we're all rooting for you. Good luck.
Thank you very much. We're going, yeah.
I'm just going to
go and conduct. Really proud of you, whatever you've done. Right? You're amazing kids. Let's go for it. Yeah? Smile.
Stop
me.
tears.
Press the gold, David. Press the gold.
It's so moving. I don't know why
it's
so moving.
Oh, my God, it shook me.
That was absolute chaos and absolute joy. Thank you so much. Simon, what did you think?
I think you are so important to kids this age to remind them, you know, to have fun. Your joy that you radiated is infectious. And this, to me, is what Britain's Got Talent is all about. David.
It's just one of the most joyous things I've ever seen. And I think you've just made all our hearts sore today. And it's what you want your childhood to have been like and what you want your children's childhood to be like, which is just full of unbridled joy. So this is what I think. Please introduce yourselves.
So I'm Jade, and what's your name? Christian. Christian is my little brother, and we're signing along with us.
How old are you?
I'm 18 years old, and how old are you, Christian?
Four.
He's four.
Four, yeah. My goodness me. Fantastic. What are you going to do for us today?
So we're here to do some sign language and some singing.
Brilliant.
Thank you. We were told that Christian would never be able to communicate. I taught him sign language so then he could talk, and he's here, a little miracle, proving everybody wrong.
Yes, sister! That's what she's supposed to do.
I didn't want to accept that Christian would never be able to communicate. I just knew that there was a voice in there that needed to come out.
Exciting, isn't it?
No.
You're so
cheeky.
We decided we wanted to teach other people this, so we started a class. We're just amazed by how many people wanted to get involved.
I'm Taylor and I'm 7.
I'm Sam, I'm 22.
I'm Ella and I'm 12.
Are you excited to see Sam and Cal?
Yes.
Yeah. I'm in love with him anyway.
Ella has actually met Simon before. She won a Child of Courage Award at the Pride of Britain 2019.
You are the sweetest, bravest little girl and you deserve this. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I can't believe I'm on Britain's Got Talent. It's amazing. It's made my dream come true.
Just got to go out there and show them what we've got, haven't
we? Yeah.
Try our best.
Amazing.
Yes.
We would never normally get an opportunity to do something like this. It's unbelievable. We're just so excited.
We wish you all the best.
Say thank you.
Don't make me melt.
To be ashamed of all my scars.
song is such an anthem for people who maybe don't feel part of the world or part of anything. And I just found it really, really moving.
Thank
you. It was absolutely brilliant.
Hello, thank you.
Gla-gla.
Thank you.
I genuinely can't find the words.
Amazing!
Thank you!
And Christian, you are an absolute little star, so thank you.
Hey, thank you.
Gargle!
I have to confess, I have a friend of mine in this choir. Ella. We met at the Pride of Britain. And I heard Ella sing, and I said, I have a feeling one day you're going to be auditioning on one of our shows. And guess what? You're here. And you're saying, this is me, and I'm thinking, you are us, because you define what this show should be all about. This is an audition I will never, ever forget.
Thank you.
Every one of you gave everything to this performance, an amazing positive message to put out there, and all I can say is
well, thank you. What's your name?
I'm Jack.
Nice to meet you, Jack.
I'm Dad, I'm Tim.
Hi, Dad, Tim. Aw, aren't you adorable? Where are you guys from?
We're from Norfolk, Norwich.
How old are you, Jack?
I'm 12.
12, and how long have you been singing with Dad?
Since I was about 5.
Really? And Tim, is this what you do for a living?
I play, I'm a full-time dad, really, to Jack, Lily, and Gabrielle and Kimberly.
Are you feeling nervous?
A little bit, but I'm really excited.
Do you think you could win this?
It's my favourite thing to watch on TV, so it would be absolutely incredible to win.
Good answer.
Do you have a favourite judge?
I like Simon especially because... I like Simon especially because I like watching his best insults.
Okay. They're good, aren't they?
They are really good. They're funny.
Okay. Probably not best to answer that question again. Can I ask a question?
Yes.
What's the song?
This is a song called The Lucky Ones. Jack and I write together, and this is one of ours.
Okay. Can you tell me what it's about?
It's we've all had family losses and things like that, and as a father and son, it's a kind of father-son song, family song. It's about us. It's just about being
how
so
lucky we are to have what we have.
Oh, well, you seem adorable, and we wish you guys the best of luck.
Thank you.
Your arms around mine.
just like you were meant to be. And all through my lives I'll be yours, say you will be mine. You.
Jack, this says it all.
I am just going to let you get on with it because we like surprises. Good luck.
Now, we all think our dogs are magical, but Finn truly is, and for more than one reason. David, I'd like you to think of an object and write that word down. Don't show me. Have you done that?
Yes.
Hold it up to your chest. And come and join us at the front of the stage. In a minute, I'm going to close my eyes. And when I do, I want you to show Finn the word.
Show him the word. Can you please return to your seat?
Now, David, there's no possible way I could know what word you've picked.
No.
Finn, what was that word? David, the word is... table. Hold that up high so everyone can see.
Oh, my God.
Now, everybody thinks that their dog is amazing, but Finn truly is.
Thank you.
Simon, can you come and join us on stage?
Yes.
A big round of applause, please, for Simon. Simon, I want you to kneel down and face Finn. For the last two weeks, we've been asking friends to think of a word that best describes Finn. We've got companion, brave, amazing, incredible, fast. Simon, can you hold your left hand like that? Now, I want you to look into Finn's eyes. Keep looking into Finn's eyes. And with your right thumb, I want you to open a page. Have a peek at that word and remember it. Simon, for the first time, can you tell us what that word was?
Heroic.
Now, there's no possible way I could know what word you were going to pick.
No.
But Finn did. Because before we came here this evening, Finn had a word engraved on the tag on his collar. Now, Simon, can you please have a look at the tag on Finn's collar and read out loud the word that's there?
Heroic.
Heroic!
Now, my dog's called Miracle, and today we're hoping to show you a real miracle.
Okay, Miracle.
Hello.
Here you go.
Hello.
Okay.
There we are. Now, Simon, I know that you love dogs.
Yeah.
So, in front of you are 40 of my dogs that are back home.
You've got 40?
I have over 40. I would like you to cut those photos into four roughly equal piles.
Okay. One. Mm-hmm.
Now, I want you to take one from each pile from the top. Don't show me. Keep one for yourself and pass three to Amanda. Just don't show me. And Amanda, if you can do the same. You keep one, pass that to David as well. Now, there's no possible way I could know which cards you've chosen. Okay? So you can see that they are all completely individual. Okay? Now, you may wonder why I have those 40 dogs. This is going to explain the story.
You with the sad eyes, don't be discouraged, though I realize it's hard to take courage in a world full of people. You can lose sight of it all. Darkness inside you can make you feel so small. But I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show your true colors, true colors, beautiful. If this world makes you crazy, take all you can bear. You call me up, 'cause you know I'll be there. And I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why
I have no idea which photos you chose, but Miracle did. And here's something that we filmed earlier today.
Right, Miracle, we've only got room to take four dogs to go and meet the Britain's Got Talent judges. So who's it going to be? Who do you want to take? Tell me. Good boy. Thanks, guys.
So, David, can I ask you to hold up the photo that you have and call out the name of the dog?
Braveheart.
Marilyn Monroe.
Grace Kelly.
Jean Harlow.
Obviously, I couldn't bring 40 that are there, but Miracle decided to choose four, so I'm going to let you meet them.
My name is Martin, and we are the junior group of Attraction.
The Attraction Juniors?
Exactly.
That's amazing.
Yes, yes, my father, the leader of Attraction, Zoltan.
Amazing. How is he?
He's fine, he's backstage.
Oh.
He's very excited.
I am not really nervous.
I bet.
I'm really nervous.
Attraction Juniors was created by my father. He performed here with Traction back in 2013. Because of my father, I think I can say I learned from the best.
Who is better, the original Attraction or the junior Attraction?
Are we better? Guys? Yes, yeah. We are better.
Oh, I love that.
Love that.
Best of luck.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Sweet. They're like the family from Sound of Music.
The Von Trapps.
Yes, they are.
Let's go and see them.
Okay, right.
Thank you.
You're always a day away.
Brilliant.
Very, very good. Bravo, bravo. Amanda.
Well, I thought that the entire piece was very relevant in this world of social media. I loved the message. It was very simple. I think you're an absolute inspiration. Well done.
You're using what you do, your talents, to make a difference, to put out positive messages. I applaud you. I love that you're Attraction Juniors. We fell in love with what came before you, and I'm excited about your future now as well. So well done, guys.
David.
It's great when a piece has a message, you know, very powerfully put. I think it's brilliant. You're doing something from the heart, and you're doing it, obviously, in this beautiful way, really imaginative way, so I couldn't fault you, guys. Well done.
I think what you did was fantastic, and I had a feeling it was going to be special. I love this kind of audition. I could see actually how moved a lot of you are. You felt the audience reaction. I love moments like this. I want to be the first person to say yes, please.
It's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
Four yeses, Attraction Juniors.
Hi! What's your name?
My name's Aidan Martin. I'm from South Shields.
How old are you, Aidan?
I'm 27 years old.
Have you auditioned before?
I did audition here like 10 years ago.
For X Factor, yeah?
It was for X Factor, yeah.
I recognise you. Do you make it through the first round first time?
I got to like boot camp.
What have you learnt differently this time round?
You know, for the past like 10 years, I've been working so hard, like trying to like do this. Like it's all I want. Like it really is.
What are you gonna sing?
I'm gonna sing a song that I wrote today called Punchline. It might seem crazy. My name is Aidan Martin. I'm 27 years old and I work in a bar. So I'll do like guest list on the door on a Saturday night. I'll pull a few pints. So I kind of just hop around, glass collecting, a little bit of everything. With me today, I've got my mum and my dad, and I'm with three of like my best mates. So I'm really happy that like, I've got some support. I was going to come on my own and not tell anyone, but I can't keep a secret to save my life.
They don't let you eat my hat.
Man, we can't say that. Me and my mum are really super close. She loves hearing me sing, loves hearing my songs. My dad's a little bit more like...
What are you doing?
I do my own song. I don't know if it's a good idea. We're judging two things, your voice and a song.
And a song.
I wrote my first song when I was 17. It just continued from there. I haven't actually like tested my songs that much. My mum says the good, so I mean, that's enough for me right
you
now.
You can't trust mums! Mums are the least trustworthy people in
well,
the world.
I know, that's
They're always going to say you're good.
I'm getting on a bit now as far as music's concerned, so if I don't hurry up, I'm going to be pulling pints for the rest of my life, and that cannot happen.
Okay, and what's the song?
Basically, just to give you a little bit of background, I was like really in love with someone, cliche as it sounds. I'm a jokey, fun person. I like to keep a smile on everyone's faces. And I guess it was just about like, I hurt and I feel like everybody else.
Who dumped who?
It was kind of like a mutual agreement, but it was so heartbreaking. Like I felt like I was-
But were you really the one who was dumped?
Yeah, yeah.
Would you take them back?
Never, ever, ever.
No.
No way. What a silly question.
You never know.
No. Right. You can't do that, ever.
Okay. What would you like to say through this song if they were watching today?
That I'm not a joke. I'm not a joke.
Well, now you get your chance to say what you want to say.
Good luck.
Thank you so much, guys. I don't know if I'm in the crowd, do I stand alone? You know all the words, but don't sing along. Every single eye has been watching me, but they don't see that I'm just another trying to find a way to hold on to your love and laugh away the pain. I don't need no cameras to see your point of view. I need someone to turn to. I guess my heart never learns. No use in finding the words if you're never here when it hurts. All your mistakes I don't wanna make. I deserve the truth, but you lie. I don't know why I'm so surprised. No matter how hard I try, if I'm just a joke waiting for the punchline, your blessing love that we found. Yeah, you laugh away, so laugh away. Said I'm just a joke, you don't know how to take. I guess my heart never learns. No use in finding the words if you're never here when it hurts. All your mistakes I don't want to make. But you lie. I don't know why I'm so surprised. No matter how hard I try, if I'm still a joke waiting for a punchline. Waiting for a punchline.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful song.
They're my words, and I'm so grateful that I can say them in front of you. I thank you so much.
I loved it, and I loved the performance. It wasn't too much. It was just perfect.
Oh, my gosh.
That song was so revealing and so vulnerable, and that takes the most strength, the most courage when someone can do that.
Thanks so much.
You have a beautiful voice. I would say this was a very, very, very special audition.
I can't believe this. I really can't.
Louis.
I could feel the emotion. I could see the emotion on your face. Every word you meant. I'm going to say yes.
Thank you so
Sharon.
Much.
Yeah, definitely. I'd like to hear you sing again.
Okay, Aiden, it's a yes from me.
Aiden, baby, you're not a joke. You're a force to be reckoned with. It's an absolute yes.
I love you so much. Thank you so much, honestly. I will not let you regret this. Where am I going? Bye!
What's your name?
McKenna Brian Holt. I'm 25.
And where are you from?
Gilbert, Arizona.
Is your family in music?
No, I actually was adopted when I was born. My family has no musical talent whatsoever. I found out I was adopted as early as I was able to understand it. My mom struggled for several years trying to get pregnant, and eventually they decided to go through the adoption process. I have the best family in the world. They've always supported me. When I turned 21, I sat my parents down and asked them to tell me any information they had on my birth mom. I just wanted to know where I came from. They told me her name was Amy Ross Lopez, and she had passed away. She was a musician who had been performing locally in Bisbee, Arizona, just a few hours away. It was a lot to process, but I instantly knew where, like, I got my ear from and where I got my voice from. It just all clicked.
Does she have an album online?
She has a few, yeah.
A few albums?
Yeah.
Do you listen to it?
I do, I love it.
Do your voices sound the same?
Yes.
Isn't that crazy?
Yeah. And then just this last summer, I came into contact with my entire birth family and found out that they all sing. My birth family was looking for me for probably the last 8 years. Knowing that I have another family out there who's equally excited to know and love me was amazing.
You haven't met or?
Not in person, but we talked on FaceTime.
Okay, FaceTime.
We're meeting in like 3 weeks.
Oh.
Yeah.
We're excited to hear you sing. What are you gonna sing
for us? I'm singing There Was Jesus by Zach Williams and Dolly Parton.
Go ahead.
Okay. Well, I'm playing on the piano as well.
You play the piano.
Please.
Wow, yes. That's great.
Every time I try to make it on my own, every time I try to stand, I start to fall. And all those lonely roads that I've traveled on, there was Jesus.
She's going to meet some of her family that is still around, her aunts, an uncle, and a grandmother.
Yep, in a couple weeks we had tickets to go out to Montana, but what she doesn't know is we brought them here with us tonight. And so...
She doesn't know,
nope.
And they're here.
Yeah.
Is that this group here?
Yeah.
You're with McKenna?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, this
yes.
is mind-boggling
yeah.
to me.
Yeah.
Hi.
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 You don't have to say anything. I can see it on your face.
In the searching, in the healing, and the hurting, like a blessing buried in the broken pieces. Every minute, every moment, where I've been and where I'm going, even when I didn't know it or couldn't see it. On the mountains, in the valleys, oh, in the shadows of the alleys, a blessing buried in the broken pieces. Every minute, every moment, where I've been and where I'm going, even when I didn't know it or couldn't see it, there was Jesus.
Very good. Very good.
That was beautiful.
That was gorgeous.
Thank you.
You're very in control of what you're doing. You're in control of being at the piano, and you're in control of singing. I thought it was great.
Yeah.
Storytelling, smoky voice, and I love the cry, the little cry in your voice that just cut right through.
That's awesome.
Okay, let me look up your mom, Amy.
Yeah, her band name is Nowhere Man and a Whiskey Girl. It's like
Nowhere
the Beatles.
Nowhere Man and Whiskey Girl.
And a Whiskey Girl, yeah. She was a wild child, but she's a cool girl.
It's gonna be like seeing a beautiful ghost, a beautiful angel. Only she's gonna be alive and I'm gonna grab her.
Do you wanna invite your family in for the final judgment?
Yeah.
Good.
Why not?
Of course.
That's gonna
be so cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I can go get them right now?
Yeah.
Sure.
Bring them in.
Okay.
It's good.
They want you to come in for the.
Oh, what happened here?
They're here.
What?
My birth family's here.
Your birth family?
What just happened?
I just said go get your family.
Everyone come in.
Wait, hold on.
What? What just happened?
I don't know. I opened the door and they're just standing there.
Okay, can I have the Lopez's on the right?
Whoa.
Lopez's-ish on the right.
What?
And the Breinholtz on the left.
Yeah. I want to touch you.
I feel like we need to give them like an hour. And
right?
Then
you
back
all want to go, so yeah.
A few days.
We'll that would be great.
I am so...
Wait, hold on. So you hold got... on. Wait, hold on.
Look at her. Is she crying?
No. Wait.
No. Yes. I'm not crying. You're crying.
That profile.
I know. Does it look like Amy?
Do you know any of your mom's songs you could play for them?
I do.
No.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
I haven't rehearsed it, but I've been playing
Tissue
it.
Tissue on Idol set.
Wow, look at this.
What song is this?
Come around.
It's called Tumbleweed.
Tumbleweed?
Saddlebags have long been packed for the trip drift north. Trails narrow to backtrack, going back and forth. Next four seasons rocky, mountain will be for our little tumbleweed. To a planet, to a man, tumbleweed whistles to the wind. His eyes at night are big and bright, deep in the heart of tumbleweed.
McKenna, you gotta be kidding me.
Thank you for letting me do
so
that.
So great.
That's Does it so... sound the same?
Oh, it's like a ghost.
God. So beautiful.
McKenna, that was beautiful.
Look, music is connection, music is emotion, music is heart. You're not the only person out there that's searching for their birth family. And there's hundreds and thousands and tens of thousands are watching this right now that are going, me too, you know? And it's wonderful to have them all together, and it's so wonderful for your mom and dad to see this and to be so open and loving and supportive about this.
Oh my God.
Sure there was a big loss for your birth family. And for you to sing like that, I think it's healing.
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
You have no idea. Yeah.
Thank you. Thanksgiving is gonna be big.
It's gonna be amazing.
It's gonna be big now.
Well, I can vote.
I'm so ready.
I'm a yes.
Thank you.
McKenna, Amy Ross Lopez told me to tell you yes.
Well, I wouldn't miss saying yes. It is an absolute yes.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You're going to Hollywood.
Peace my heart, man.
Oh,
I love you.
I love you too.
What's your name?
My name is Jasmine Elcott.
Jasmine, how old are you?
I've turned 14 2 days ago.
Oh, happy birthday.
Thank you.
Who have you brought with you?
I've got my dad with me here today and my mom.
Brilliant. Well, this is 2 minutes that could really change everything. So good
luck. Thank you very much. Thank you.
To believe it, but after
Russell.
Oh, she deserved that.
Oh, thank you, thank you.
You know what? I was at one point losing the will to live, thinking maybe all the talent has gone. And now you come back, little thing, with such a great voice, so charming. And let me tell you, I think this country is going to totally fall in love with you.
For so many reasons, that audition moved me so much. I've never been this much of a mess on the show. Literally. Oh, my goodness. I hope all your dreams come true. You deserve it. Really do. Whoa.
Oh,
look.
Well done,
guys.
Come here.
Oh my gosh,
thank you.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Shall I go?
Yes.
Let's do it.
It is all yours. The very best of luck, Colin.
Thank you.
Enjoy.
We actually know each other. Welcome to Britain's Got Talent. For those of us who haven't already met you, can you introduce yourself?
My name is Colin Thackeray. I'm 88. And as you can see, I'm a Chelsea pensioner. My name is Colin Thackeray, and I live at the Royal Hospital at Chelsea, hence my uniform. It's a happy place to spend one's retirement. I've been singing for 80 years in various ways when I was in rank in the army, and it was good fun. The song I'm singing this afternoon is called The Wind Beneath My Wing. It's in tribute to a really lovely lady who I love very much. My wife and I were married in 1950 for 66 years. I never got any promotion in the army before I met her. So anywhere I got was entirely due to her gentle support all the time. Joan died in December 2016, and she died in my arms. She was sitting in her chair, and she suddenly said, Colin, instantaneous, I knew she was dying. And she died in my arms. I miss her like mad. I talk to her all the time, tell her what's happening. But she knew I was on this stage. I think she'd be rather chuffed, really. But I should be very proud to sing to her, because she was truly the wind beneath my wings. I'm going to sing you a song that is dedicated, actually, to my late wife.
Colin. I think it's extraordinary you've come here. The stage is yours.
Thank you very much.
It must have been cold there in my shadow. To never see sunlight on your face. You did your best to make me shine. You always walked a step behind. I was the one with all the glory. Why, you were the one with all the strength. Beautiful face without a name. I never once heard you complain. that you're my hero. And everything that I'd like to be, I could fly higher than an eagle, 'cause you are the wind beneath my wings. It might have appeared to go unnoticed, but I have it all here in my heart. I want you to know, I know the truth. I would be nothing without you. Did you ever know that you're my hero? And everything that I'd like to be, I could fly higher than an eagle. You are the wind beneath my wing.
Somebody to know, somebody to feel, somebody to have, just to know how it feels. I was getting kinda used to being so.
Well, I'm Colin.
Well, Colin, there is not a dry eye in the house.
Thank you.
Well, it was just the most perfect tribute, and you sung with such heart that it affected all of us deeply. It was beautiful.
Oh, Colin, I really, really loved that. You show to everyone it's never too late to do the things you love and to sing about the people that you love. That was wonderful.
As I was listening to the words, I've never thought of it before, thinking that all of the men and women that fought for their country are the wind beneath our wings, because if it wasn't for you, we wouldn't be here. Congratulations, it was a lovely tribute.
You are going to have a moment, and it was sincere and it was real, and you are what the show is all about, so thank you. Let's start with David.
I'm going to kick this off with a very easy yes.
It's a yes from me, Colin.
And from me.
Got four yeses.
Now the day bleeds into nightfall. You're not here to get me through it all.
Four yeses.
Yeah.
We'll see you next time. Thank you, sir.
I look forward to that.
Thank you.
I was getting kind of used to being someone you loved.
Hello. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
All right. What's your name?
Grace.
Where are you from, Grace?
I'm from Blackburn.
Okay. How old are you?
I'm 20 years old.
And what's your work?
Well, I work in the warehouse, packing vinyls and stuff, and I also write and sing. And
great.
Just
that's okay. This,
yeah, just singing.
That's where everybody starts off, Grace.
Yeah.
When
yeah.
did you start writing?
Probably when I was about 16. My first song was about 6 minutes long, so I've had to sort of get around that. But yeah, I've been basically writing ever since.
And are you going to do original songs
for us
today?
I am, yes. I'm going to sing my own song called Roots.
Great. Good for you.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Thanks.
Found out. I don't wanna leave this town.
I started from, cause my roots won't keep me warm. They won't keep me warm. But they said I was always gonna be that way. Until I saw you, I believed them every day. And then you came my way. Oh, let me love, oh, let me love you until we're old. Oh, let me love, oh, let me love you until we grow old. Cause my roots will never keep me warm. I guess I made it here somehow. I made it this far and I am proud of some hold. Change, nothing stays the same, and I, for one, am glad. I never knew I wanted you so bad. But they said I was always gonna be that way. Until I saw you, I believed them every day. And then you came my way.
Oh, thank you. Yes. So
wonderful. Tell me what that song was about.
I've been singing in pubs and restaurants and things like that just for years, since I was 16 to 18. And not just friends, but everybody was just like, you'll be doing that forever, singing Amy Winehouse in the corner of a pub. It was just that thought of, like, this is what I want to do, and it makes me so happy. And just being able to say, actually, I did do it.
Grace, it's very rare when someone sings an original song, I say, yes, I love it. That is a hit song.
I have to tell you, I loved it, genuinely, and I really like you, Grace.
Thank you so much.
My God, this is a beautiful, beautiful song. I mean, beautiful song. Louis.
Grace, follow your dream. You've got the talent. Big yes.
Sharon?
I can't wait to hear more of your original material, so it's a huge yes from me.
I would like to get that song off you so I could listen to it. It's an absolute yes.
Thank you so much.
I've said this before, I don't believe there is any such thing as a perfect first audition. What you, however, have just done is to demonstrate very, very, very clearly who you are, what you're all about. It's genuine, came from your heart, it's believable, and that's why I'm excited to say that you have your fourth yes.
Bless your heart. So lovely.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm doing well, how are you?
Well, we're good. I mean, you know who you are, right?
I'm the last one, yeah. I do know that.
You're the last person to audition for season 22.
Wow, I can't believe it.
Well, who are you?
My name is Julia Gagnon. I'm from Cumberland, Maine.
Beautiful up there.
You were raised in Maine?
I was raised in Maine. I was born in Guatemala.
You were born in Guatemala. How did you make your way to Maine?
Yeah, so I was adopted by my current family.
Oh. That's when we became parents.
No.
This is one of my favorite pictures.
Aww.
When I was 2 years old, I was adopted out of the orphanage in Guatemala and was brought to Maine.
This is at the end of your first night.
You were so tired.
Growing up in Maine when I was younger was a dream come true. It was picture perfect. There was snow at Christmas and warm summers, and it was all amazing. When I entered the school systems, it became different. I got bullied a lot. In Maine, not a lot of people look like me, and it was really hard to deal with and still is hard to talk about, sorry. I don't think I have ever found a place where I feel like I fit in, but I have found my support in life, and that is my family.
Thank you all for coming. We just didn't necessarily expect everybody to come.
They're amazing. I love my parents. But at the same time, I grew up very curious about my birth family. I went to my dad when I was 18, and I said, it has nothing to do with you. I just need to know. And he was very understanding.
Have you had any communication with them at all?
I did find them, yeah. My dad hired a private investigator in 2020 and found them.
Well, that was really cool of your dad.
Yes, I owe him a lot for that.
When they found my birth mom, she wrote me a letter. She thanked God that my parents raised me for her, but she was very apologetic, and she did let me know that she didn't want me to go. But she was happy that I did, because the life that she could have given me wouldn't have been anything compared to the ones that my real parents gave me. My birth mom, she knows I can sing. She said that she would love to live to see me do something big.
That's why I'm here, to do something for her, so.
What do you mean to do something for her?
I felt really helpless because I can't go to her. Guatemala's really far, but she's really proud of my voice and she wanted to see me do something big.
Well, what are you gonna sing for us?
I'm going to be singing Ain't No Way by Aretha Franklin.
All right.
Yes.
Let's go big.
Yep.
Ain't no way.
Thank you.
Did that come out of your mouth?
I think so.
When you hit the amazing falsetto, and then you turn the volume down to it beautiful, and then
I loved that. Look, you've got, I think, several soul singers that are inside of you. Not just one, you've got several. And you could go really far, you could be top 10.
Thank you so much, thank
you. I am in shock. I grew up with Aretha Franklin. There's certain songs you just don't sing because you just can't touch the original. And you just made it not only your song, but you did things that it's just beyond.
Thank you.
That was amazing.
Amazing.
That was absolutely outstanding.
Thank you.
I'm gonna vote. I'm just gonna say I can't wait to get to it. Yes, yes.
Thank you.
What's your mother's name?
Which one?
Your birth mama.
Sarah.
Sarah?
Yes.
You're doing something big, and it's for Sarah. It's a yes.
Thank you.
What's your adopted mother's name?
Meg.
Meg?
Meg.
Well, we love Meg, too. I'm a yes.
Thank you.
And that means
You're going to Hollywood.
Oh, my gosh. Thank you.
Please come get this.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
When the judges asked what my mom's name was, I distinctly remember saying, which one? I meant that because both of them have such an impact on me.
Thank you so
much. God bless you. We'll see you in Hollywood.
I'll see you in Hollywood.
Hi.
Hi.
What is your name?
I'm Caitlin.
And how old are you?
I'm 18.
And Caitlin, who are you here with?
My mom and dad. I live at home. We're all a really, really close family. We do absolutely everything together.
Caitlin's a real daddy's girl. Two of them are really, really close.
Caitlin always sang from a very early age and just has always been a love of her life to sing.
I took part in school talent shows, and then I started doing like my own videos on social media and stuff. I started to get a little bit of negative comments from people at school. And it got to a point where I didn't want to keep singing anymore. I always used to go home like crying most days. It just really gets to you, like, you don't know why you listen to all that. Like, my dad just was like, stop this. You are good enough, which kind of boosted my confidence a bit.
It was a difficult time at a point, but she's got through that now, and I think it's actually made her a stronger person for it. It's a huge thing for Caitlin today to be here, huge.
What would it mean to you if you got through today?
I've had a lot of knockbacks with at school. I got bullied quite a lot, and so my dad used to always tell me like to keep going, and so did my mom. So today I want to make them proud.
Why were they bullying you?
They just didn't really take for my singing, but hopefully you guys do.
Hopefully we do. All right, sing your heart out.
Thank you.
And all I remember is your bed, walking towards the airport, leaving us all in your bed. I traveled 1,500 miles to see you. Begged you to warn me, but you didn't want to. But piece by piece, he collected me up off the ground where you abandoned things. Yeah, piece by piece, he filled the holes that you burned in me at 6 years old. And you know, he never walks away. He never asks for money. He takes care of me. He loves me. Piece by piece, he restored my faith that a man could be kind and a father could stay. He'll never walk away. He'll never break her heart. He'll take care of things. He'll love her. Piece by piece, he restored my faith that a man that a man could be kind and a father should be great.
Oh, she went and done it. She went and done it.
That was all right. You're a force to be reckoned with. I never like cry about this stuff, and it's not even about me. But when you're talking about your parents, and
that song was for like my dad, like picking me up when I was down and stuff. So that's why I kind of did it.
I have the same thing. Like my parents, I don't ever talk about them, but I'm nothing without them. So just related to you on that level. So, anyways, you're awesome.
Thank you so much.
Caitlin, I think 15 years ago, I was on a show in America, and a girl came in and told me she wanted to be a star and hadn't had a break, and her name was Kelly Clarkson. And then she went on to win American Idol. For a moment there, when I heard you singing the song, it was like going back 15 years.
I think you're the best singer we've had. Something about you, you've just won us all over, I think.
Thank you so much.
But we have to vote. Louis.
Caitlin, I'm saying yes.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
Nick.
Say yes from me.
Thank you.
You've got three yeses. I have to say something. Do you know why sometimes people get bullied? It's because they're good. Because you're good.
Thank you so much.
Come in.
Thank you.
What up, you? What up?
Thank you so much. Bye.
And that's why we make the show. I told you we had to come to Scotland.
Nice.
I knew we were going to find great talent here.
Nervous, nervous, nervous.
The biggest audience I've ever performed to is probably like in a school assembly. And so it's quite a big step up coming here today. It's like quite scary, yeah.
Before you go on, I'm gonna ask you, is he any good?
Yeah.
It was a little pause.
For the presentation. You ready to do it?
Yeah.
They're ready for you.
Go look
out. All yours. Have fun out there.
Thank you. Today's definitely gonna be like the biggest day of my life. Four yeses from the judges would be the best thing ever.
He's very tall.
Hello, what's your name, please?
My name is Harry Gardner.
How old are you?
I'm 16.
Where are you from, Harry?
I'm from Essex.
Okay. So, tell me why you've decided to enter this show.
I just want to kind of share my music with other people and see if they can relate.
Okay. And Harry, what are you going to sing for us today?
The song I'm going to sing is a song that I've written. It's a song for my nan. And it's a song called Not Alone. My nan, she was diagnosed with Alzheimer's 3 years ago.
Oh.
Yeah, this song's a tribute for her.
Has she heard this song before, Harry?
Yeah, I did play it to her. She wasn't really, like, aware of what was going on. She looked happy, which was just nice.
Okay, well, I can't wait to hear it. Good luck.
Thank you very much. Open your eyes and tell me what you see. Am I among the forgotten? Please say you remember me. We know you're there somewhere inside. I say a prayer for you to smile. Looks like the angels owe me one today. But I stay strong, I know it won't be long till I see the old days. Open your eyes and say hello. Open your mind and just let go. Tell me to get the remote so we can watch your favorite show and ruffle my hair and say it's bad and tell me this chocolate in your handbag. Tell me just how much I've grown and let me know I'm not alone. We understand good things don't last, but I'd give anything just to hear you laugh. Looks like the angels owe me one today, but I stay strong. I know it won't be long till we see the old days. Open your eyes and say hello. Open your mind and just let go. Tell me to get the remote so we can watch your favorite show and ruffle my hair and say it's bad and tell me this chocolate in your handbag. Tell me just how much I've grown and let me know I'm not alone. And let me know I'm not alone.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Harry.
Thank you.
Amanda.
Harry, that it really moved me. I just wish your grandmother could see what you've done today because I'm sure she'd be so proud of you.
Thank you so much.
I really think it takes real courage to put your heart and soul and vulnerability into a song the way that you just did. And it was a fantastic audition.
Writing a song about something that means so much to you. You did it with such emotion and passion. It was just beautiful.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
It's quite rare that I could remember an audition a month or 6 months later. And this is one I'm going to remember because it was very genuine. It absolutely showed your talent as a songwriter. Yeah, I like you, Harry. I think people are going to get you. We're going to vote. David?
I'm going to say yes.
Alicia?
Easiest yes of the day. Yes, yes, yes.
It's a yes for me. Well done.
Harry, guess what? Four yeses, get ready for the next round.
Brilliant. Well deserved.
Thank you so much.
Well done.
What are you here, Christian?
I've been singing, you know, on and off, like, as a little child, but a couple of years back, went to an Ed Sheeran gig.
Yeah.
I saw him just standing there on the stage, just with his guitar. I just wanted to be that. I wanted to be him and do what he's doing.
But you know with him, it's all about the songs, you know that.
I mean, I write songs myself, so...
Can we hear one of your songs?
You can, yeah. I've got a song I wrote for my brother, who passed away when I was only young. And it's just a song that, you know, means everything to me, and only my mum's ever heard it. So,
do you want to perform it?
I can do. I feel like I'm ready.
It's entirely your choice, Christian.
I feel like I'm ready to.
You
perform
sure?
It. Yeah.
All right, take your time.
You good? Yeah.
I would do anything just to be 2 years old again. Imagine what we could have done. Imagine what we could have been. Making a paper plane till the sun goes down. I'll be holding your hand as you're squeezing onto mine. Hold on tight, we said never let go. Remember building castles out of old legs.
go, just to knock him down. See he's changed now, you're not around. I'm not the same, but I hope you're proud. I wish your little face was still around, with that cheesy smile and them little chubby cheeks. Imagine all the mischief we get up to. Imagine us tag team 1 + 2. Imagine all the good, bad, sad and happy times. Imagine all the time out, naughty step crimes. Stay up late, watch TV we couldn't watch. We'd go to school, break the rules, play hopscotch, and climb trees, chase bees just to act tough, and fight, 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 fight over brother stuff, and sneak out late, play football till the sun goes. My thunder buddy, I will keep you safe as you doze off to sleep, bed bugs and counting sheep. Off to sleep, night, night, baby brother sleep, until we meet again. Stay safe, my friend, and I will keep you in my thoughts till the very end. My little Teletubby in the sky with a smile, my little thunder buddy, I will see you in a while. I miss you like the sun on a rainy day, when the stars come out to play. Oh, oh, I miss you, and I miss you, and I want to be with you, my friend. I just wish we could be two again.
Thank you for sharing that with us, Christian. Nick?
Honestly, Christian, on the first song, I didn't know if I got you. And then you wrote that second song, and I was right there all the way, and you got me, so thank you for that.
Louis?
Yeah, Christian, it was a very honest audition. I think you buried your song.
Yeah, very beautiful song. Very beautiful. I like you a lot. You're very pure in what you do. It has a great charm to it.
Thank you.
You know what, Christian? It was very brave to share that song with us because it is so personal. I don't know how you did that, but I think it was important that you did do it, actually, because it told me and us who you were as an artist, and actually as a person. And you've got a real talent. I think you're great with lyrics.
Yeah.
And I like you. Louis?
Christian, I'm saying yes.
Sharon?